abbreviation of VUCA, where V stands for volatility, U for uncertainty, C for complexity, and A for ambiguity.
Volatility means it is the equality of being subjected to the frequent, rapid, and significant changes.
U stands for uncertainty. It means lack of predictability in issues and events.
Complexity, that is the potential chaos and confusions.
A stands for ambiguity, that is lack of clarity about the events.
So, before jumping ahead, let's know about something about the history of VUCA. Where does word VUCA came from?
The term VUCA was introduced by the US Army War College around 90s.
It came up as a result of extreme conditions in Afghanistan and Iraq.
And reflects the increasingly unstable and rapidly changing world.
Later in 2009, one of the business leaders, Bob Johnson, mentioned the term VUCA in his book named Leader Make the Future,
where Bob Johnson spoke about disruptive forces of change that affects business environment. Here, disruptive forces means a step change that transforms the society forever.
So, why it is necessary to talk about this? Why it is necessary to talk about VUCA? So, as you all know, world is facing the disruptive changes. The world is facing the quick changes. So how to cope up these changes? I would like to give you an example of the rapid changes that are happening, and the companies are getting shut down because of that. Let's take an example of the Jet Airways, which is one of the largest airlines in 2017, and get insolvent and shut it down. It's all its operation in 2019.
Changes are leading to uncertainty. As we know, we live in an ever-changing world. So with this changing world, it is difficult for a person to predict a change and change himself overnight.
People, companies are facing problems in adapting the rapid changes. They are not ready to face the unknowns. So, as my friends say, that the changes happening overnight cannot be predicted. So I would like to give example of a company which faces a problem in getting with the rapid changes. I hope everyone has heard about BPL, a television company of 90s. It is a famous television company which produces color TV boxes, and it doesn't get changed with the rapid changes around the world. It doesn't get changed with the environment of LCD and LED TVs and got shut down.
Unable to predict future from past experiences. From past experiences, we cannot predict the future and change our business. Here, I would like to give an example of Nokia, where Nokia was not able to change its plans and was unable to recognize the future supermarkets of mobiles.
The most generic phrase in the language today is, we have always done it in this way. So we have to change this. So now, how to survive in this VUCA world? How will we survive in this rapidly changing world with the technologies? So very first is
learning agility. We need to be agile. We need to change ourselves very quickly to change with the quickly disruptive, dramatic, and this changing world.
Critical thinking. We have to think critically about the threats are coming up, about the changing happening around the world, about the opportunities.
Innovative decision making. Innovation is the key to success, and we need to be creative and innovative to live in this world.
Think globally. As you all know, all the business changes happens globally. So we just need to extend our boundaries to the global level so that we can cope up with the changes and match the competition.
And it is also important to anticipate the threats and take the advantage of new opportunities.
So here, before starting that, I would like to give an example of a product company who are trying to survive. As you all know, there is a disruptive change 2 years back in the telecom industry, which is about, from nowhere the Jio came up in the telecom industry and it captured all over the market. But there are some companies, just like Idea, Vodafone, they are not able to match up with the changes happening around. So what they did, after some time they got merged. That is a strategic plan to cope up, to get competition with the Jio and cope up with the changes. They are trying really hard and hopefully they will survive.
As companies are taking VUCA to survive in this world, so it is also necessary to change the old version of VUCA to a new version that is called VUCA 2.0 or VUCA Prime. It is a new concept that was introduced by Bill George, a senior fellow at Harvard Business School.
Volatility will be constrained by the vision of shaping up the things, vision of how to face this changing world.
Uncertainty is countered by understanding where all the team members come together with the same mindset and change to try the world.
The complexity will be countered by the clarity. Clarity of thoughts, clarity of vision, clarity of goals, clarity of future planning, so that the decision will be made clearly.
And ambiguity transformed to agility, and we want to be an agile leader to change with these quick changes.
So coming up to the conclusion, VUCA is the new normal for the business environment nowadays.
It is changing the traditional businesses and leadership approach. More strategic, complex, critical thinking skills are required.
Agility is the key ingredient.
Technology and man has to go hand in hand. Thank you.
Thank you. It's a VUCA world.